Welcome to Game Pickups, The Return. Yes, 55. Yes. 31 games, I remembered. Short-term memory fail. But yes, 31 Gimgams in the past couple of weeks, the bulk of whom were purchased today. It was payday yesterday. Today. Yesterday. Yesterday. And, yeah. Bought some games. But, to be fair, I've always said I've always wanted a box of games. I've not bought a box of games, but I found a box of games, and I took my pick of the litter. So, yay, got 31 games, bulk of which I bought today, because I found a box in my favourite charity shop, which is awesome. A couple of accessories and a couple of bits and bobs. First and foremost, before we get to the pickups, hi. Yeah, I keep disappearing when I'm saying I'm back. Don't ask me how or why, but I have a few days off work coming up, and I haven't made any plans for them. So, I'm hoping to get something done then. Mostly of which, to review this damn thing. Yes, I've already said I'm going to review it, and I never bloody seem to, do I? Yes, the MK8092. Picked it up probably sometime last year. Need to review that. Need to review these piece of shit glasses camera thing. And I also need to review this freaking awesome thing. Yes. The Telex you like. I may have shown it in one of my Game Pickers videos. I'm fairly certain I did. And yeah, it's a little Android tablet with controls. And I'm going to do a full review on that because I'm playing the absolute hell out of it. Oh my god. Even more than my JXD, which is scary. Even more than my WikiPad, which has a failing screen, which is more failing than ever. So let's get to the pickups before we waste more time. Technically Game Pickups related, right? Right? Who's this guy? You should know who this guy is. Yes! It's Rip Hunter from DC's Legends of Tomorrow. Ha, I lied. It's, of course, David Tennant as the Doctor to go with my TARDIS and Cyberman up there. He's going to go right next to it. Found it in a charity shop today. I was like, hey, that'd look really awesome next to my TARDIS. So that it will. And there has been Doctor Who video games, so I'm counting it. Stop judging me. So yes, Game Pickups, proper Game Pickups now. This crappy little thing, got it for free. Whatever. I can't remember if I had any. And it's for a Wii controller. I honestly can't remember if I had any. So, I picked it up. I think I do, though. Probably, somewhere. And I also picked this up for a few quid. For a few quid. Literally a few quid. In cash converters, no less. Yeah, they had two of them. I picked up one of them because the other one was a bit grubby. So yes, it's another Wii Classic controller. Absolutely fantastic controller. I've fully endorsed these over the years, and I also remember showing them in a Android video, because believe it or not, these work on Android 4.1 and below. You can actually use a Wii Classic Wii controller on your Android tablet. It's great for emulation and stuff, so it's a fantastic little controller. Definitely awesome, and has many applications for it. And thus ends the Game Pickups accessories, I think. That is literally it. I didn't really pick up many bits. There weren't many bits to be had, most of which are games. So, let's do retro first. I know you guys like your retro first. Actually, I'll do these first, because they don't actually know. Well, yeah, we'll get to the retro. Why the hell not? So, I've always wanted to own this. I've played it emulated forever, because they are my favourite games of all time. And I found it on eBay in an auction for 99p, and no one else bid it on it. Boom. Galaga and Galaxian. Oop, there we go, autofocus, you behave today. Yes, Arcade 3, Classic 3, I imagine there was a whole bunch of these. I know there was a bunch of these. I play them emulated all the time because I've got every freaking game under the sun for all retro systems. Because, the games were tiny. But yeah, I'm glad I finally own this. This is going pride of place in my collection. It's going to go in a very happy little game. I've got a case ready for it and everything, and it's going to go straight into there because this is one of those that deserve a case because Galaga is a brilliant game. Now this one I ordered from abroad, and it took a while to get here and arrived a few weeks back, but because I was taking a small little hiatus from Game Pickups, and it's still on hiatus by the way, I'm going to make them as and when I have a bunch of games. So you might not see one again for another couple of months. Maybe. I don't know. I can't predict the future. I didn't predict today. Finding a bunch of games. But yes, RoboCop 4-in-1. Now, I don't know if these are the actual RoboCop games or hacked ROMs. I don't know. I have no idea. Because I wanted a whole bunch, all of the RoboCop Famicom games and the NES games. But I figured I'd opt to get this because it was dirt cheap from abroad. It comes with RoboCop 4, RoboCop, RoboCop 3, and RoboCop 2, apparently. It says it in the tiny yellow writing. There you go, autofocus. So, yeah, we got... I don't know if it is or not. I'm going to have to play it and find out. I think it is the actual games. I'm not too sure, though. But, yeah, I'm glad to own it just because I like my RoboCop. Autofocus, behave. It's been a while since I've used it. I think it's warming up. Picked this up recently for a couple of quid. Chicane for the Sega Mega Drive. Fun little game. Can't remember it because I ordered these things weeks ago and they just arrive then and then I forget about them because they're on the gaming pickup shelf. Next up, Strider. Looks familiar, but I'm assured that I don't already have it. Yes, Strider for the Sega Mega Drive. Always a good game to pick up. Why the heck not? This one I'm not too sure about. The original Prince of Persia for the SNES. Yeah, did you know I picked that up?
No.
Yeah, exactly. She likes the Prince of Persia. I wonder how you'd like the old retro Prince of Persia. Probably not. But yes, Super Famicom America. So, yeah, you know how I like my American cards, and I found this one dirt cheap compared to the PAL version. So, naturally, I picked this one up because of my Super Retro Trio, which is beautiful. We've had a little bit of a tiff, me and the Super Retro Trio. It's regarding the SNES games because, you know, me being a little amateur and not doing my research, I found some incompatible games, which you guys should have warned me, but I won't hold any grudges, right, guys? But yeah, I knew about the SNES lockout chip inside the console. I kind of overlooked the ones inside the cart. Yes, so when you put the game into the Super Retro Trio, it comes up as, this game pack is not designed for your system, and you're like, fuck you, Nintendo. So yeah, I'm currently trying to find a way around that, but it's highly unlikely. The best option I have is to buy a Japanese SNES, which is, it's not the end of the world, I'll take that. I mean, it beats owning a PAL one and an American one, so win goes there. Next, I picked up a game in a sleeve. I think it's like my second or third game with an actual sleeve. Saves me actually printing one off. Still in the process of doing all that because I've got a lot of retro games. Little Nemo Dream Master. It looked kind of cute. I looked at the gameplay. It was actually very adorable. Yeah. Don't know if it's based on a movie or not. It definitely looks like one, but can't place it. Probably because it doesn't exist. I'm probably thinking of Pagemaster. Probably. I don't know. Or My Little Toaster. Not My Little Toaster. Whatever his name was. Can't remember. Next. Dreamcast game. Yes, I showed some love to the Dreamcast. I found this for a quid. Jeremy McGrath, whoever the hell he is. I should probably know by now because I've got a million of games with his name on. Supercross 2000 for the Dreamcast. On GD-ROM, of course, as you can tell by the disc. Yeah. Picked that up. Comes with the manual, which is nice. Shame I don't have any cases. That might change, as you'll soon find out. Hidden and Dangerous, found that for a quid as well. Boom, can't go wrong. Hidden and Dangerous, great game. I do have it on PS1, I believe. So having it on Dreamcast, even better, because it'll look better. Maybe, possibly. Yes, Berk. Alright, let's get to the PC games. Found this one today for 25p. Microsoft Combat Flight Simulator 3. I might even already have it. I swear I have a flight simulator game, but I've got that many, I just don't know. I don't know. I checked my game list, it's not on it. But then again, I haven't put any of my PC games on the game list yet. I haven't got around to it. I keep going, right, I'm going to do it now, look at the time, and I'm ready to just go to bed and get off of work, so. Happens every time. In fact, I'm doing this Game and Pickups video pretty late, and I'm going to go to bed straight after this. So, yeah, fun times. Combat Flight Simulator Battle for Europe. I wonder if it's compatible. Let's have a look. 2000 XP, 98 Millennium. It might be compatible with my flight controller. What is it, the HOTUS X? Yes, the controller got dirt cheap because of an error in the system. But yeah, these were the ones I was actually wanting to show you a little bit earlier. I want to read a PC education game. But I bought not one. Not two, but three I want to read. They were about 20 pence each. And do you want to know why I bought these? I was curious about the inside, so I opened it up. And lo and behold, there's the one I've opened, this one. Lo and behold, it all comes on a disc. Now, let's examine the game case here for a second. Of the game case. The software case for these PC games. Now, let's have a look at them. Mm-hmm. Take notes of the size and the dimensions if you live in the PAL regions. Mm-hmm. Yes. Almost identical to PlayStation 1 cases. It's slightly smaller, so I'd have to do a tiny trim off a little bit of the cover to actually fit it in, which I am more than happy to do just to have it in a flipping case. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to strip these, get rid of the crappy software. It's some learning software from like 1998. For good old MS-DOS and all that. I'll keep the disc, one of them, for a laugh, and then probably donate the rest. But either way, yeah, got three of them, and I'm going to try getting the rest. There were a whole bunch of them in Cash Converters for 20p. Unfortunately, the ones that were 20p were damaged. The ones that weren't, which had also been there for a very long time. I know they've been there for a long time. They're freaking old games. Nobody wants them. Literally nobody wants them, but for whatever reason they're selling them at like 127 each, and I'm like, we took them all up and we were like, right, what's the difference between this one, which was an I want to read, yeah, there was an I want to read one for £1.27, yeah, one for, what was it, 60 pence or whatever it was,
yeah,
and one for 20 pence, which were the ones I bought here, the ones for 20 pence, and they just said it was something to do with the time they came into the store, and I was like, that doesn't make sense. They are all three identical. By the way, they are new and sealed. I've just taken them all out of the packaging. They were all brand new sealed. They were never used. But I'm going to try and haggle them down, because I have haggled them down before. To my surprise, you remember I think it was 3 or 4 or 5 Game Pickers videos ago, I actually haggled cash converters down. So I'm hoping to do it again at some point next week and get the rest of them. I will offer to buy the whole lot of them. Which, they are, when they've had something for too long and they think it's not going to sell, if you talk to the manager, they're more than happy to get rid of them sometimes, so. Awesome. So let's get to the other games before making this video stupidly long. Boom! Let's go on to the modern games and then on to the slightly older ones. First one, Scrim. Yeah, I picked up Scrim. All these games were £2 each, I believe. I'm really disappointed in the Skyrim copy. I didn't really look too much into it. I just saw them all, grabbed them, the ones that I'd be interested in. I know Skyrim runs like absolute crap on PS3, but I don't have it on PS3. But upon closer inspection, the case is absolutely smashed at the bottom. There you go. Don't know why you can see that. I can't really bother going into it, but it's absolutely smashed. And don't even get me started on the disc. Does the disc look okay to you guys? You can see me through the disc. So I don't even know if this thing can even be read. I'm assuming it'll be fine because this side is immaculate, as most Blu-ray discs are. But the fact is, they've absolutely scraped the crap out of the top. And I've had a few CDs, but they were CDs back in the day. I don't know if it counts on Blu-ray, or maybe I was just unlucky. But I remember scraping the cover off a CD back in the day, and it just wouldn't work because I assume the laser went through the CD or something like that. I don't know. But I'll try it out and let you know if it works. But yeah, really not impressed with that one at all. Next one, Gran Turismo 5 Prologue. I think I've got it. No, I've got Gran Turismo 5 Academy. I believe Prologue's the one that comes out before the actual game comes out. I don't know what the difference is between them, but Gran Turismo 5 Prologue, why the heck not? Ghostbusters, the video game, absolutely fantastic game, and it's got most of the guy, or all of them back, I think, for the voices, I'm fairly certain they did, I don't know, but yeah, Ghostbusters, the video game, pretty darn fun game, comes with the manual and game, which is awesome and makes me happy and moist, but I don't know why this is a bundle copy, I imagine it came with a wheel or a console, but Project Gotham Racing 4 for Xbox 360, only on Xbox 360. You can keep it. But I'm hoping this one works with the wheel. You know that awesome wheel I bought for £3? That is actually really, really good. Should probably do a review on that maybe one day. That's for later, though. I'd rather do reviews on these awesome softwares first. But yes, yeah, Project Gotham Racing. I like my Project Gotham Racing, so hey, I'll take that. Why the heck not? Next, Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End. No, I didn't buy it for £8. I would never be that silly. Yeah, this was in the box of £2 games. Case, again, knackered. These games weren't looked after at all. But the discs were, which is all that matters, really, isn't it? This one, unfortunately, doesn't come with a manual. I'll have to put that entry in the gaming list when I eventually put it on. I didn't even know this came out for 360. Or if I think I did. Actually, yeah, I think I did, but I've forgotten many years ago. Because obviously I never had a 360 until recently. So, Guitar Hero 2 for 360. Don't even have a guitar controller yet. But I will. And it'll go up with them over there. Got one for the Wii, got one for the PS3, got one for PS2. I need one for the 360. UFC 2010. It was there. I didn't have it. Why not? I can't really talk about it. But I can talk about this one. Prototype. Oh, one of the best games I've ever played. It does... In my opinion, it gets boring after a while, but it's a stupidly fun game for a lot of hours. You'll find yourself really enjoying it, gaining more powers, upgrading and everything. It's basically Infamous. They're so similar to Infamous. Infamous and Prototype, it's so similar type of games. So if you liked Infamous, you'll like Prototype. That's pretty much all I have to say about it. It's a really, really good game. The sequel's just as good, and yeah. I already have this on PS3, but I figured I'd get it on 360 because the girlfriend likes a Prince of Persia, like I said, so boom, got Prince of Persia, which has a lot different art than the PS3, which I was quite surprised by. But yeah, Prince of Persia for the 360. I'm assuming it's the same game because it's just Prince of Persia. I think it's like a prequel to them all or something. Fatal Inertia for the 360. Of course, the disc isn't in properly because that would make sense. Comes with a manual, of course. This one I got from Segs quite a few weeks ago. I think it arrived just after I released the last video. Yeah, I bought it when I bought... What did I buy from Segs? It was I think it came with the SSD, but then if it did, I would have shown you. Yeah, it might be and arrived after the video. Possibly. I'm not too sure, though. And, of course, last 360 game is Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag, which I found for $3.99 in cash converters. Yes. I only bought it for that price. I don't even know if you can get it cheaper elsewhere, but finding it for $3.99 on the 360 genuinely impressed me. Mostly because this is probably my favorite Assassin's Creed game ever. I think it was everybody's favorite Assassin's Creed game, and probably still is. It hit the pirate theme perfect, the music, everything. The only parts we didn't like was when it took us off the ship and had us do Assassin's thing. I don't want to do Assassin's thing. I want to be a pirate, damn it. So, yeah, that was... Yeah, but still absolutely fantastic game. And, yeah, I now own it on the 360. I remember buying it for a tenner on PS3. Grr. Ah, well. If you wait, you get them cheaper. Next, Transformers Prime, the game. No idea what this is. I just know I didn't have it. Doesn't come with the manual. Of course. Apparently it's two-player. That's helpful. Stage an epic assault on Megatron's army as the Autobots from Team Prime. Battle head-to-head as one of 11... Oh, it's a fighting game, is it? Okay. Or maybe it's got both. I don't know. Either way, Transformers Prime, the game, doesn't really say much. No idea about this one. Play timeless classics. Classical music, pop music, and much more. Choose from over 50 songs. What? Try an array of instruments with your Wii controller, I guess. Oh, you can even use the Wii Fit board thing. Good job, I've got two of them. Do I have two of them, or did we donate one? Might have got rid of one of them. I can't remember. But yeah, jam with friends, go solo, send your music videos to friends, play the drums, blah, blah, blah. No idea. And this one I've wanted for a while, but I could never find it for a good price because despite it being a Mario game, it's a very unpopular Mario game. It's not a very good Mario game. It just features Mario for the sake of featuring Mario. It's just a football game. Mario Strikers Charged Football. Mario and his friends are back on the football pitch, and now the challenge is even bigger thanks to the Nintendo Wi-Fi connection. Unleash a powerful Mega Strike against your opponent, blah, blah, blah. So yeah, it's not a very popular one. In fact, it's probably not any good, but it's what I wanted because I like to have Mario games. It's a Nintendo console. I want them. Iron Man. Thought I didn't have it. I do. On the Wii. Yes, I've even got it on the Wii. It's over there. It's one of them right there. Yeah, well, not too bothered. Two copies is better than none. Iron Man for the Wii. The Lord of the Rings Two Towers on Xbox. I have it on PS2. Didn't have it on Xbox. I found it. $1.99 though, I was a little disappointed about that in cash converters because everything else was 50p, even all the other Xbox games were. But this one stood out and was like $1.99, so I was like, whatever. I'm not going to argue with you. So, yeah. Lord of the Rings, Two Towers. Fun game. It is a fun game. The Lord of the Rings games, despite being licensed EA titles, they're actually pretty fun. They are fun. So, that's speaking of fun, this isn't. And apparently it's only on Xbox. If only that were true, eh? Eh, we all know how shit this game is. And it's not the worst game in the world, but it's a very terrible Deus Ex game. But yeah, it was 99p. And I didn't have it on Xbox. I mean, I had it on PC. I've had it on PC forever since it came out. Didn't like it too much. But it's an okay video game, so yeah. It's not all in Xbox. Why are you lying? Yu-Gi-Oh! The Duelist of the Roses. I don't even know if I have this. I don't even know. I literally found it on the whim. I picked up all these Xbox and PS3 games and Wii games and went on to the counter and I saw a little pile of games on there which had the flight simulator on it and this one on it. So I was like, whatever, I'll take them too. So yeah, for 50p I got new Yu-Gi-Oh! Game. I mean, I like playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a good little card game and I enjoyed the show. The show taught me a lot about the actual game, which was nice. It was nice not having to read a rule book. But yeah, me. Monster House? I think that's based on a movie. Explore the living, breathing Monster House. I'm fairly certain it's based on a movie or TV show or whatever. But yeah, Monster House. And boom, that's all she wrote. Boom. Done. Yes, we are done. And yeah, I even used this. Yes, my little game bit. It's actually really good, and it's magnetized, so it holds the bit in, which is nice. I do like that. So if you have any retro systems, definitely get a game bit. Helps you clean them out as well, which is really handy. But yes, I'm off to disappear again for another few weeks. I do plan on making videos. Not too sure about gameplay ones. While I have been playing a lot of Fallout lately, that's the only game I've really been playing, and I don't know if I want to make any more videos. Or any, have I made any videos? I don't think I've made any videos on my YouTube channel. Just live streamed it. Either way, yeah, I've just been playing Fallout 4, waiting on that DLC because I've got the Season Pass. Of course I've got the Season Pass. I'm not the biggest Fallout fan in the world. Ain't I Vault Boy? Ain't I Vault Boy? Ain't I Pip Boy? Ain't I bloody tin and everything? So anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Take care.